ಅನುದಿನ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್
ಯೆಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್
ಕಸನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
Hello children, how are you? I hope all of you are good and doing well. Today we are going to learn a new lesson from your 9th standard third language English textbook. Let us see. Before going to start, I want to give you a pre-reading activity which is a very easy one. I hope all of you can do it. Think of your grandfather. Make a list of the daily activities he does. I hope all of you have a grandfather at your home and you might have observed his daily activities and you might have noticed him very well. Can you tell me one by one and make a list of his activities? Then I will give you one example. What he does? He goes for a morning walk. Isn't it? He goes for a morning walk. Then can you tell his other activities? Okay, is even? Okay, you can tell. Then see the second one. He plays with the grandchildren. You might have played with him in the garden or in the playground, isn't it? Then see the next one. He shares his past experiences. His experiences are very valuable, and so he wanted to share his experience with his grandchildren. Then he tells stories of moral values. Grandfather and grandmothers are well known for their night stories. They tell stories to their grandchildren. You might have heard good stories from your grandfather, isn't it? See, here is a grandfather. He wanted to teach his granddaughter some values in a different way. You are going to learn this in the lesson 5. In your textbook, it is lesson number 5. See, it is the visit. The visit. Let us see. This grandfather and this granddaughter, where do they go? What do they visit? Let us see. This lesson is written by a well-known author. Now let us know about her. Her name is Debbie Harman. Debbie Harman is a teacher for physically challenged children. She is from Germany. This author belongs to Germany. She is an author of interesting books for children. This Debbie Harman has written so many books for children. She enjoys narrating stories of value to children. She says that life is beautiful because of love and care. Debbie Harman wanted to teach new values to children through her stories. She says love and care are more important to live a happy life. This lesson, The Visit, is a story that tells us about a cute granddaughter and a grandfather. Here, granddaughter and grandfather are here. This story tells about them. It also says how love and affection revive hopes. This lesson tells you how love and affection revives our hopes in our life. There is a magical power in a true relationship. Relationship must be very true. The bond between the relation should be very tight. Then we will enjoy our life. This story is taken from the anthology Pearls of Hope, published by Aspire Printers, Hamburg. This is the story taken from a collection of short stories, Pearls of Hope. Let us come to the lesson. I will read. Listen carefully. Okay, children, shall I start the lesson? Okay. The name of the lesson is The Visit. Every Saturday, Grandpa and I walk to the nursing home, a few blocks away from our house. We go to visit many of the old and sick people who live there because they cannot take care of themselves anymore. Whoever visits the sick gives them life, Grandpa always says. First, we visit Mrs. Sokol. I call her the cook. She likes to talk about the times when she was a well-known cook back in Russia. People would come from miles around just to taste her famous soup. Next, we visit Mr. Mayor. I call him the joke man. We sit around his coffee table and he would tell us jokes. Some are very funny, some aren't, and some I don't get. He laughs at his own jokes, shaking up and down and turning red in the face. Grandpa and I can't help but laugh along with him, even when the jokes aren't funny. Next door is Mr. Lipman. I call him the singer because he loves to sing for us. Whenever he does, his beautiful voice fills the air clean and strong and so full of energy that we always sing along with him. We visit Mrs. Kagan, the grandmother who shows us pictures of her grandchildren. They are all over the room in frames, in albums, and even taped to the walls. Mrs. Schreiber's room is filled with memories. Memories that come alive as she tells us stories of her own experiences during the old days. I call her the memory lady. Then there is Mr. Krull, the quiet man. He doesn't have very much to say. He just listens when Grandpa or I talk to him. He nods and smiles and tells us to come again next week. That's what everyone says to Grandpa and me, even the woman in charge behind the desk. Every week we do come again, even in the rain. We walk together to visit our friends. Who are the friends? The cook, the joke man, the singer, the grandmother, the memory lady, and the quiet man. So, this is the model reading of this lesson that I have taken. I divided it into a small unit. So, you might have come across some new words in this lesson. So, let us see in the glossary section. Shall we learn new words? Okay. Let's have new words from this lesson. The first one is nursing home. Do you know what is nursing home? Yes. Nursing home is a place of residence for people who require constant nursing care. It is the home of old and sick people. Let us use this word in your own sentence. Can we do it? Yes, I know. You can use this word in your own sentence. Let us see, what is it? Nursing home. Grandma came back from home. Grandma came back home from the nursing home. Let us move on to the next word. Sick. Sick. Do you know sick? Yes, sick means in poor health. Can you use this word in your own sentence? Okay, you can. Sick means Ashok is suffering from fever, cold and cough. He is sick. Ashok is in sick condition. He is suffering from fever, cold and cough. The next one is blocks. Blocks means a residential building consists of flats. Here you can see four blocks of buildings. These buildings consist of flats. You know flats. What do you mean by flats? The use of this word in the sentence is, my uncle is living in C block, flat number 12. Next word is album. Album is a book of photographs. All of you know this word very well. Use this word in your sentence. See, Kiran kept his birthday photos in an album, isn't it? Okay. The next word is can't help. Can't help means not be able to avoid a situation. Some situations are unavoidable. We have to go through it. Such situations are called, we can't help. Use this word in the sentence. I can't help but shopping clothes when I go to a big mall. When I go to big mall, I can't control myself and I go to purchase new clothes. Okay? Then move on to the next word. Next word is taped. Taped means fixed or pasted. You know, tapes, gum tapes, paper tapes, we use them to fix something on the wall or on anything. So, then use this word in your sentence. Suman taped a picture on the top of her notebook. Suman taped a picture on the top of her notebook. Let us see the next word. Nod. Nod means as to indicate agreement. Nodding means moving your head upward and downward. Use this word in your sentence. Can you do it? Yes, I know you can do it. Let us see. My father gave a nod when I asked for a new dress. When I requested my father a new dress, he nodded his head. It means he gave his agreement. Okay, children. Next, move on to another word. Memory. Memory means what is remembered, what we remember, what we keep in our mind. It is memory. Use this word in our sentence. What is it? See, Sanvi has good memory. She can tell mobile numbers of her friends by heart. She kept the mobile numbers of her friends in her memory. She can recall any time. Okay. The next one is in charge. In charge means in a responsibility of. Who is in the responsibility of something or some building or some institution is called in charge. Let us see its uses in sentence. As the captain was injured, vice captain took in charge of the team. In absence of the captain, vice captain took the charge of the team. Okay. The next one is well known. Well known means famous. Use this sentence in your own. Use this word in your own sentence. See, Sachin Tendulkar is a well-known cricketer. Sachin Tendulkar, you know, he is a well-known. Well-known means famous. He is a famous cricketer in this world. So, children, we have gone through all these new words we have come across in this lesson. Now, let us move on to the lesson. Shall we? Okay. See, the name of the lesson is The Visit. The Visit, it is a visit by grandfather and a granddaughter. Let us know where do they go, what building they going to visit. See, every Saturday, grandpa and I walk to the nursing home, a few blocks away from our house. Here, hi means the author Debbie Herman. She walks with her grandfather on every Saturday to a nearby nursing home, which was few blocks away from their house. We go to visit many of the old and sick. They go there to visit the inmates of the nursing home. The inmates of the nursing home were old people and the sick people who live there because they cannot take care of themselves anymore. The people living in the nursing home, they cannot do their work their own. So they were living in the nursing home. Whoever visits the sick gives them life, grandpa always says. What does grandpa says? He says, whoever visits the sick gives them life and hope. In the beginning, I told you, love and care may revive our hopes of life, isn't it? So that's the thing grandpa want to tell his granddaughter. So he wanted to teach this value to his granddaughter. So he takes on every Saturday to the nearby nursing home to visit these sick and old people to bring hopes in their life. First we visit Mrs. Sokol. There were many people in the nursing home. In that building, they first visit Mrs. Sokol. I call her the cook. Debbie call her the cook because she likes to talk about the times when she was a well-known cook back in Russia. This Mrs. Sokol was in Russia. Now she is living in a nursing home. She likes to talk about her cooking because she was a well-known cook back at that time in Russia. People would come from miles around just to taste her famous soup. People from all around came to Mrs. Sokol just to taste her soup, famous soup. It was not an ordinary soup, it was a very famous soup. Next, we visit Mr. Mayor. I call him the joke man. Debbie call this Mr. Mayor as a joke man. Why? Because we sit around his coffee table and he would tell us some jokes. This Mr. Mayor was very famous in telling jokes. That's why Debbie call him the joke man. His jokes, some are very funny, some aren't. Not all his jokes are very funny. Some of them are very funny and some I don't get. Some jokes of Mr. Mayor were not understood by Debbie. He laughs at his own jokes, shaking up and down and turning red in the face. The joke man laughs at his own jokes. Grandpa and I can't help but laugh along with him. Grandpa and Debbie, they could not control themselves. They also laugh along with the joke man, even when the jokes aren't very funny, because they wanted to make him happy. He had the habit of telling jokes. So if anybody don't laugh at his jokes, then he would stop his jokes. That's why even the jokes aren't funny, Grandpa and Debbie laughed at his jokes. Okay. Next door is Mr. Lipman. I call him the singer. Mr. Lipman was called as the singer by Debbie because he loves to sing for us. The Lipman loves to sing for both grandfather and Debbie. Whenever he sings, his beautiful voice fills the air, clean and strong and full of energy that we always sing along with him. His voice was very melodious and beautiful. When he begins to sing, his voice fills the air and it makes other people to sing along with him. Then we visit Mrs. Kagan, the grandmother who shows off pictures of her grandchildren. Another person was Mrs. Kagan. She loves to show her grandchildren's pictures to grandfather and Debbie. The pictures, they are all over the room in frames, in albums, and even taped on the walls. The grandmother, she pasted all the pictures on the wall. Mrs. Sreebar's room is filled with some memories. Memories that come alive as she tells us stories of her own experiences during the old day. Mrs. Sreebar's, she is very fond of telling his experiences, old day experiences to grandfather and Debbie. That's why I call her the memory lady. Okay. Then there is Mr. Krull, the quiet man. He doesn't have very much to say. He just listens when grandpa or I talk to him. He is a quiet man. He loves to being a quiet man. He can't talk too much. So he just loves to listen to grandfather and Debbie. What he does? He nods and smiles and tells us to come again next week. He didn't say much, but whatever grandfather tells, he just nods. He just nods his head and smiles at them and asks them to come again next week. That's what everyone says to grandfather and me, even the woman in charge behind the desk. Who is in responsibility of that building? A woman. She also requests grandfather and Debbie to visit their nursing home again and again. Every week we do come again. Even in the rain, we walk together to visit our friends. The cook, the joke man, the singer, the grandmother, the memory lady, and the quiet man. These were all the inmates of the nursing home. These persons are all visited by grandfather and Debbie. Okay, children, this is the lesson we have learnt so far. Let's move on to vocabulary section. This is a very easy one. In vocabulary section, we are going to learn a new activity. See, what is there in it? Here is a list of words and two columns A and B. You have to match the opposites. See the words in column A and then match the opposites of these words from the column B. Isn't it? Laugh, remember, good, finish, dry, and these are all well-known words. I hope all of you know these words and you can do this activity very easily, isn't it? Okay, let us see. Laugh. What is the opposite of laugh? Yes, cry. The next, good. What is the opposite of the word good? Bad. Yes. Then remember, the opposite of remember is forget. Finish, start. Dry, wet. Isn't it good, children? You have learnt the opposites of these words. Okay? Okay. Let's move on to the recapitulation of the lesson. I know all of you have learned this lesson very well. Now, I am going to ask a few questions about the lesson. I hope all of you can answer these questions very well. Shall I ask the first question? Okay, let us see what is it. Where did Grandpa and Debbie go every Saturday? Where do they go? It's an easy question. See, Grandpa and Debbie went to the nursing home every Saturday. Isn't it? Okay, let's move on to the next question. Who did Grandpa and Debbie meet in the nursing home? Who did they meet? See, at the nursing home, they met many of the old and sick people who cannot take care of themselves. The nursing home was for the old and sick people. These grandfather and granddaughter went there to meet those people. Okay? Let's see the next question. What does Mrs. Sokol like to talk about? Mrs. Sokol, what does she like to talk about? Let us see. Mrs. Sokol likes to talk about the times when she was a well-known cook back in Russia. She was a famous cook back in Russia. She loves to talk about her cooking. Okay? Let's move on to the next question. Why would people come to visit Mrs. Sokol? Why do people come to visit from the miles around to visit her? Because people would come to visit Mrs. Sokol just to taste her famous soup. Isn't it? Okay. Move on to the next question. How does Mr. Lipman entertain Grandpa and Debbie? See the answer. Mr. Lipman entertains Grandpa and Debbie by singing with his beautiful voice and also makes them to sing along with him. His voice was very beautiful and melodious. Whenever he sings, he makes others to sing along with him. Okay. See the next one. What did the memory lady fill her room with? There was a memory lady. She filled her room with some things. What were they? See the answer. Mrs. Sribar, the memory lady, filled her room with memories of her old days. She pasted many photos of her old days on the wall of her room. Isn't it? Okay. These are the questions we have recapitulated through these questions the whole lesson. Now, children, now the time for homework. Can you do it? Yes. I hope you have listened to this lesson very carefully and you did all the activities very actively, and I hope you can do this homework also very well. Let us see what is our homework. Here is a question for you for homework. Why did Grandpa and Debbie visit the nursing home? All of you know why Grandpa and Debbie went to visit the nursing home. Can you write the answer for this question? Yes, I hope you can do it well. Let us see the next question. Write the opposites of the following words. We have did a writing an opposite activity in vocabulary section. You can also write the opposites of these words. Let us see what are those words are. Few, first, strong, up, and odd. These all words are chosen from the unit we have learnt just now. Okay? This is the lesson, The Visit. Children, thank you for listening. This is the end of the lesson. My name is Rashekar B. Jinkeri, assistant teacher from KPS Rangampet, Taluka, Shorapur, district, Yadgir. Okay? Thank you.